Then one day, evil was found in Lucifer. Now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Lucifer, the one who would later be known as Satan, the accuser and the adversary, came also among them. And God said to Lucifer, O Lucifer, son of the morning, why is it that I find unrighteousness in your heart? Lucifer responds, I am Lucifer, the bright and morning star. Look at my beauty and look at my splendor. It is beneath me to serve the inferior being that you call man. Are we not higher than that worthless creature? Yet you have proclaimed that weak human your crowned creation, setting him over the works of your hands. And you plan on making us subject to this weakling? Will man be our judge? No! I will not allow man to be my judge, nor will I be subject to him. But I will take away his dominion and make it my own. All the kingdoms of the world will be in my hands, and their glory shall be mine. I will be the god of man's world, and man will bow down and worship me. For I am the swiftest, I am the strongest, and I am the wisest of all your sons. Who is like unto me, and who is able to make war with me? I should be sitting in the temple of God as God, showing to everyone that I am God. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God, above all the angels. I will also sit on the mount of the congregation on the farthest sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High.
Good day, friends. You've seen that video clip. Satan said he will take the dominion away from man, and that exactly happened in the Garden of Eden, and all the kingdoms were given back to Satan. And of course Satan said unto Jesus, bow ye before me and I'll give you all the kingdoms of this world. I will give it unto you. Of course Jesus did not resist that temptation. He said, get behind me, Satan. And he resists Satan, he resists the temptation. The only man that successfully ruled the world was King David. And that was Satan's kingdom. Although David himself went through a lot of temptation, he was the only king that I know that successfully ruled. One of the kingdoms according to God's standards. Yeah, but the rest of the kingdoms, they do belong to Satan. And Satan gives it to whoever he wants to give it. Although God is in perfect control, God allows it to fulfill his will. Yeah, today the Antichrist, false prophet, is from a Christian nation, and we're specifically dealing with Isaiah 14, 13 and 14. And here you find the 12 tribes of Israel. There's Judah in the south, Simeon was right here in the middle. And then you have Dan here towards the coast, but later Dan moved further northwards. If you can see, there's a city called Dan. There's a city called Dan. That's in the area that they moved to later on, much closer to Damascus. It's actually in the Mount Hermon. We'll come to that in another video about Dan. And here is the rest of Manasseh and Ephraim. They were both the sons of Jacob. Remember, Joseph had a double portion. And Ephraim, we're going to hear a little bit more about Ephraim. Now, yeah, so the Antichrist, false prophet, is from a Christian nation, the farthest side of the north, Isaiah 14:13 says, I will exalt my throne above the stars. That is Satan speaking. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. And when I read that, I immediately think of America's stars And actually, there's 13 stars, and that represent 13. 13 means rebellion. I will also sit on the mountain of the congregation. Listen carefully what it says. I will also sit on the mountain of the congregation. Of the congregation. What does that congregation mean? Normally we speak about congregation as a church, as believers in Christ, on the Father's side or the north. Mountain in the Bible always mean an empire or a country. And America is not an empire, but a superpower. The greatest superpower that you get, that's on the earth today. I will also sit on the mountain of the congregation on the further south of the north. And this looks very much like a mountain. We all know the White House. Washington, D.C. This may easily be interpreted as the Antichrist sitting in the middle of the congregation, in the middle of the congregation, in a Christian country, which represent the 10 lost tribes of Israel in the north. He is the leader of this mountain in the north. Israel is always the time clock. Not the Assyrian Empire, or that's what most people say, yeah, the Antichrist will come out of a Muslim country. No. There's no Christians there. It says clearly here, I will also sit on the mountain of the congregation or the farther side or the north. Anybody has that? That idea that the Antichrist and the false prophet rise from the European Union and out of the old Roman Empire. No, that's not. We don't live in the ancient days. We live in our generation. We live in our generation. And as I state, if one look at Israel nearest, yes, the map of the previous, it's another map, it's just a little bit smaller. If one would look at Israel nearest would be the Jews. South, the furthest would that be. Israel is north, the 10 lost tribes, where are they today? They are spread throughout the world. Ephraim is America, people. And if you remember the prophecy of Jacob, when he called Joseph in, he had Manasseh and Ephraim before him, and he crossed his hands. And of course, Joseph rebuked him for that matter. And you can read about that prophecy. And of course, America is the youngest, England is Manasseh, and the birthright went to Ephraim. Now it's a promise made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob that their offspring will be like the sand of the sea and the stars of the sky. This promise was never made to Shem, Ham, and Japheth. I did deal with this subject in another video, but I will go over it again in this video because it is important to understand, because you will argue with me and say, no, America is not Ephraim. So many of us is from Israel, stems from Israel in every nation. No wonder Yeshua said in Matthew, the tribes of the earth will mourn. He said the tribes of the earth. The tribes of the earth, so that means they spread all over the world, will mourn when they see him in the clouds. And this is the 12 tribes is spread with the same map. Simeon there, Judah there. And this is where they got the allotted land when they moved into the promised land. Now, yes, as I said, You, we all are the 12 tribes of Israel. After King David's son Solomon died, the Israelites divided the one kingdom into two. Yes, they divided the kingdom in two. The northern kingdom was called Israel and included 10 of the 12 tribes. Of course, you see, Simeon was right at the south, but when they divided, he went northwards, joined the other 12 tribes as well, including Dan. In fact, Dan moved right to the north, close to Mount Hermon. We're coming back on that. As we all know, that Dan was not included into the 144,000. This is very interesting, people. Very interesting. I'm going to deal with that subject in another video. So do set your notifications for that. Watch out for that video. There will come some wows when you hear about Dan himself. Yeah, now living in the north were the tribes of Reuben, Manasseh, Issachar, Zebulun, Ephraim, Dan, Asher, Naphtali, and Gad. The southern kingdoms was called Judah, including the tribes of Benjamin and Judah. Immersed throughout both kingdoms were members of the priestly family of Levi. Now, in 722 before Christ, Assyria conquered the northern. That's the northern here. So the only Judah remained. Assyria conquered this division. You can also see that in another video of mine. After 70 years, that's a good teaching about what happened with the kings in those days. So you can watch out for that video after 70 years. I also deal with the same subject there. Yeah, the southern kingdom was conquered by Babylon, the temple temple destroyed, and the Jewish people taken captive. Only 42,600 Jews returned to the promised land after 70 years in Babylon. The rest spread throughout the world in every nation and island. Yes, they spread all over the world. That's for the last 3,500 years. They spread right over all the nations of the world. Many people say the 10 tribes is lost. They are not lost. You are one of those 10 tribes. And you'll see it now. Only the three tribes, Benjamin and Judah, that is called Jews, they rejected the Messiah and they still reject him today. The tribulation, Jacob's trouble, is for the Jews. No. It is not for the Syrians or for the Roman Empire. It is for the Jews because they rejected the Messiah. Yes. They will be born again during this time. They will get saved out of Jacob's trouble. And that is what the Bible says. The rest of Israel, the lost 10 tribes of Israel, are saved. Yes, they are saved. The Gentiles, you are. The lost 10 tribes are the Gentiles, people. The Gentiles. The lost 10 tribes of Israel are saved. The Gentiles, the stars of the sky and the sand of the sea is in every nation of the earth. And Jesus called them the tribes of the earth in Matthew 24. Yeah, Yahweh promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob that their offspring will be like the sand of the sea. Imagine the sand of the sea. You can just take a handful of that sand in your hand and try to count it. It is beyond number, even at the hand of sand. And Jesus said that their offspring, didn't promise it to Ham, Shem, and Japheth. Ham, Shem, and Japheth. He promised to Abram, Isaac, and Jacob. Yahweh dispersed the Israelites into nations. As I said, imagine picking up a handful of sand and count it. Almost every person on the earth is an Israelite, like it or not. God chose himself, a chosen nation, Israel, to counteract the plans of the enemy. And if you want your answer to that, if you don't believe me, Deuteronomy 8:64 tells us what happened to Israel. Deuteronomy 28:64, and the Lord shall scatter thee among all the people from the one end of the earth, even unto the other end of the earth, and there thou shalt serve other gods, which neither nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone. You will serve. They did not keep the commandments, therefore they were scattered, intermarried into every nation. Almost every person on earth is an Israelite, and most people do not know it. Well, I am from the tribe of Isaac. I asked God from which tribe I am, and God did answer me. I'm from the tribe of Issachar. Yahweh promised to Abram, Isaac, and Jacob, I will cause your descendants to become as numerous as the stars of the sky, and I will give them all this land, and through your descendants all the nations of the earth will be blessed. You are blessed, my people. You are Israel. It says here, I will give them all these lands, and through your descendants, you are a descendant of Abram. Even Galatians 3 mentioned that all the nations of the earth will be blessed through you. Yeshua states in Matthew 24, the day he will appear in the clouds. All the tribes of the earth will mourn when they see him. Matthew 24:30, and then shall appear the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven in great power. Coming back to the Antichrist false prophet is from a Christian nation. I have to give you that information so that you can have an understanding. Right, from that point, all the 10 tribes are spread throughout the world, as well as the southern tribes. Later, the southern tribes were Judah and Benjamin, and of course Levi itself were deported to Babylon, and they stayed there for 70 years. They returned, and of course only 42,600 returned. And when Jesus came, they were again about plus minus 5 to 10 million people in Israel itself. And AD 70, again, they dispersed into the world again. And they, of course, all moved through the southern part, through Africa. That is where they were dispersed. And of course, later in 1948, Israel became born again, born in one day, in 1948, 14th of May. Therefore, the Antichrist will speak blasphemies against God and exalt himself above God. And we've seen in Isaiah 14, 13 and 14, that it says the Antichrist is from a Christian nation. In first, second, Corinthians 3, 2, 3, and 4 says exactly the same thing. Paul says in 2 Thessalonians 2:3-4, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day will not come unless the falling away comes first, and the man or son revealed. Because we all know that the false prophet and the antichrist can only reveal themselves after the rapture. The Bible said, the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. And once the first fruit of the church is been removed, the gates of hell will prevail. Did you hear that? Do you understand that? So those people that say that we will go through the wrath of God is untrue. It's untrue. Here the word clearly states that he cannot reveal himself unless the church is the first fruit of the church has been removed. Whoever opposes and exalts himself above all is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he sits as God in the temple of God, showing himself he is God. The Greek word for Paul uses for the temple of God has a meaning of a spiritual temple of God. Moreover, in 1 Corinthians 3:16, Paul says to the Christians that we are the temple of God. 1 Corinthians 3:16. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? Therefore, Paul says the Antichrist and the false prophet, of course, arises among the Christians who are the temple of God. Remember, Revelation 13 mentioned two beasts, the first beast and the second beast. Both of them have the same power and authority. In other words, they actually one. They are part of the satanic trinity. That's the dragon, the false prophet, and the antichrist. And here we see King Trump sits on a mount, also in the White House, in a Christian country. This is precisely what Isaiah says in chapter 14:13. Prophet Isaiah says that the Antichrist will sit on the mountain of the congregation on the farthest sides of the north. That means the 10 lost tribes of Israel who became Christians are those who are far away in America. They are Israel, and she is called Ephraim. She is called Ephraim. The secondary Messiah was referred to by the Jews as Messiah ben Joseph, sometimes referred to as Messiah ben Ephraim, because he will descend from the tribe of Joseph through Ephraim. Ben Joseph, that is Donald Trump, is from Ephraim, America. Ephraim does not symbolize some modern entity or nation, but represents the 10 tribes of Israel. It is more than possible that Donald Trump is from the tribe of Dan. I mentioned Dan earlier. Dan is not in part of the 144,000. Manasseh came in there in the place of Dan. Yes, and of course Joseph as well, because Joseph get a double portion. Is from one of the 10 tribes. Yeah, it is more than possible that Donald Trump is from one of the 10 lost tribes known collectively as Ephraim, and as I said, he is from the tribe of Dan. Now that is why the Mahadi arises in the Christian country, America. Obama is called the Prince of Israel, the profane Prince of Israel, and the wicked Prince of Israel, Ezekiel 21:25. This Muslim Antichrist is the leader of the Christian country, America, and Obama is Muslim. He is definite Muslim. And if you do know not about Obama has a seal, and this appears in the Quran. Obama has a seal called the sun comes up in the west, and the day when the sun comes up in the west, Obama will reveal himself. This Muslim Antichrist is the leader of the Christian country America, and Obama is a Muslim. This is a solid interpretation of the identity of the Antichrist based solely on the very clear Bible verses. This disqualify, and I say it again, this disqualify any candidate for the Antichrist arising in a Muslim country or from the Roman country. You say, yes, he's a Syrian, he must arise out of Syria. No, the word the Syrian is a title like Mr. Doctor. That is advocate, that is a title. It's a title. A Syrian is a title. This is a mortal blow to all the theories about the Antichrist as being a Syrian or arise from Persia, Turkey, or any other Muslim country. This immediately qualify Obama for an eligible candidate for the Antichrist. This qualify the Antichrist, false prophet, must arise in a Christian country which represent the 10 lost tribes of Israel, and that country is America, which is called Ephraim. As I say again, see the prophecy of Jacob to Ephraim and Manasseh. Ephraim is America and Manasseh is England. The requirement of the Antichrist must come from the Middle East is a preconceived notion. The Syrian is a title of the Antichrist, which I said before, which is only one among the following titles. Obama will be the Mahadi. The Assyrian, Isaiah 10:5. The king of Babylon, Isaiah 14:40, the prince of Tyre, Ezekiel 28:2, the profane prince of Israel, Ezekiel 21:25, the wicked prince of Israel, Ezekiel 21:25, which is a title, people. You got it? It's not the country. Obama is 69 times removed from Antiochus Epiphanes, if you do not know that. Antiochus Epiphanes is the person that defiled the temple years back ago. He was the first one to defile the temple. And Obama is 69 times removed from Antiochus. So he is actually a great-great-grandchild of Antiochus. And that is in his genealogy. However, Israel will get Trump first as Ben Joseph. You have to study what the Jews believe to understand the end times. From their perspective, you have to see it from their perspective, because ultimately Jacob's trouble is for the Jews, and they will get saved out of it. So you also included those that are stubborn, that doesn't have oil in the lamp. You will stay behind in the tribulation with Satan when he is being cast down to the earth. I pray for you. I pray for the lost. I really pray for those that even have to go through that tribulation. But I believe you will get saved out of it. You don't need to stay behind. You can make up your mind right now. Get into the ark. Get into the ark right now. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. Yes, as I said, however, Israel will get comforts as Ben Joseph, the suffering one. And right now on the scene, he appears to suffer. Everybody hates him. Everybody is against him. He can't build a wall. 16 states vetoed against Trump. But yeah, as I said, that is all said that the wall will not be built at all because it is part of the NAFTA, of NAFTA. And NAFTA is a nation under the Antichrist rule. Now, when Obama makes his appearance in the last 3.5 years, Israel flee to the wilderness, Revelation 12. He makes war with Israel and defeat them. That is in the middle of the tribulation. And if you remember the 15-year-old boy that died on but he died on a blood moon during a Feast of Trumpets, and he died, and then he went to heaven or somewhere, wherever he went to, and he received information from Jesus, and he said that God, who is God? It is Obama that do it. Obama will defeat Israel in 2 days. He will defeat them and then they all flee. He makes war with Israel and defeat them, taking over Jerusalem as his capital. So that's it, folk. Thanks for watching and please do subscribe to my channel. Press the notification button. And please share this video with everyone. It is important. If you believe this is the truth, which the scripture says it is, then do share it with your friends. Yeshua is standing at the door. Give your life to Yeshua. God bless.